Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us today in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we'll learn how to move resources between resource groups. And for that, we have Aisha Ghaffar, who's going to show us how to do that. So thank you very much for joining us today, Aisha.
Thank you so much for having me, Leon. I'm really excited to show you all how to move resources between resource groups in your Azure environment. This is a customer need that many customers like you have. And so today I'm going to show you the different places in the portal where you can accomplish that.
That's awesome. Let's see it.
Sounds good. Okay, so let's try to move some of our resources in the Azure portal. So you can see that I've landed on Azure Home, and you can see that I have, you know, some of my favorite services on top that I've recently clicked on, as well as some of my resources. And so there's three different places in the portal that I like to use to move my resources. One is the Azure Resource Mover. And so let's go, it's conveniently right here, but you can find it in Global Search, or you can also find it in All Services, in the All Services catalog. But let's go to Azure Resource Move. And you can see that I have three options. I can move my resources between subscriptions, to another resource group, or between regions. Today, we're going to show you what it looks like to move to another resource group. So I come here and I pick my source subscription and my source resource group. So if I remember my source subscription correctly, it's going to be this one and this one. And I also have to pick my target one that I want to move to. So let me just move it to a random one for the purposes of this demo. And then you can see that I'm trying to add resources. And so once you go here, you can like add the resources. They show up in this context menu. And then I can pick the resources that I want to move. And then, of course, we have our pill filters here in case we have lots of several resources, but I only have three. So I can just see them and click on them. And I'm going to click on select. They'll show up here. And they're going to be in this validation state where I need to check that, you know, click on next and then check that these resources can be moved. So the portal is going to be running some backend operations to see can we actually move these resources. And so it's going to be in a validation state for quite a while. But once it checks and it's successful, then it'll look like this. The validation state status is succeeded, and then you'll click on next, and then you'll have the opportunity to double check that, you know, the source and the target is correct, the number of resources that are moving. You have to accept that, you know, some things will not be moved with it, like the tools and the scripts, and then click on move, and then it'll start the operation. And so that's essentially what the flow looks like. But you can, like I said, you can access it from a couple of different places. So we did this from resource move, but I also want to show you a couple of other places that I like to do it from, which is the resource group itself. So I'm back on home, and you can see that I can, the resource group that those resources were in is this one. And so you can see in the overview that I have like the same resources that are showing up, the same ones in that context pane. So I can click on here and I can just use my commands in the command bar. So the same options that I had in resource move between to move to another resource group, subscription region, I have it here in the command bar. So I can click on move to another resource group. This one in particular, it like knows that this is a target subscription. So I just will pick like, you know, anyone, and I'll go on as we did before. Another thing that you can do is also just to move the resource itself without having to go to the resource move. So let's go back to home. And, you know, if I wanted to move just that resource, I can go to the resource itself and still, you know, use the command bar, which will have like two of the options. It won't have between regions. It will just have a resource group and subscriptions. And so then I can proceed in that same flow where what we were doing earlier. One thing I want to note though is the nuance between what types of resources you can and cannot move. And so here, let's go back to the resource group view. Here you can see that I have a database and a server. I was moving both of them at the same time. If you notice something interesting, you'll see that the name of the database has a server like within parentheses. That's because the database is a child resource of the server. So one of the things that might happen is if you just try to move the child, you'll run into an error because you really need to move the parent. You'll get an error message, you know, and you'll see, you know, what is the parent. And in fact, you only really need to move the parent because once you move the parent, the child will move automatically. But if you want to be really sure, you can just select both. And there you have it. That's how you move resources in the Azure portal. This is something that we updated and launched a new UI. So we definitely would love feedback on this. So please reach out to us. You can find us on Twitter, or you can just actually give feedback right here, or you can also give feedback right here and provide feedback to us if this is something, if you like this experience, or if you'd like to see some improvements. So thank you so much for watching this demo and for spending a few minutes to learn about how to move your resources in the Azure portal.
That was great. Thank you very much, Aisha. And as Aisha said, please try it out. Let us know what you think. Leave us a comment in the comment section. Follow us on Twitter. You can reach out directly to us too. And thank you very much for watching. Look forward to seeing you in the next video. And bye for now.